considering features of ODL material, you must have understood that it's not an easy task. Right from understanding who is the target group till planning entire learning material design, lot of efforts are involved. Most importantly, systematic instructional design is needed to develop such a material. Let's understand how we can go about it. When we say that it requires proper instructional design, we need to understand stages and phases of instructional design development. In any instructional design development, there are some common phases: analysis, design, development, evaluation, and implementation. We generally use abbreviation ADDIE for these stages. What do we do in analysis stage? Instructional designer who is going to develop this open and distance learning material should be very clear with all analysis. First, we need to understand why this material is being developed. What is the need of this material? For whom are we writing this, and why do they need it? This is need analysis. Need analysis is actually filling up gap between what is current status and what is to be presented. So from current status, if we want learners to go somewhere, reach somewhere, what is the gap? Answer to the question why this gap needs to be filled will give need analysis. In which context this material is going to be used is another question. Target group's culture, target group's learning environment is context. Context analysis gives us answers: where is learner going to study, where does learner come from, and what are the challenges of learner's context. For example, if you are going to use computer or tablet or online learning, first you need to understand whether the learners have this infrastructure ready. If you are developing this material for rural learners, has internet reached to their doorstep? Whatever material you are developing, does that material require very high-end computer? If not, then can you develop some mobile learning material? If even mobiles are impossible to get, can you develop some print material? These answers will be sought by context analysis. What content are you giving them? What is the nature of the content? What is the vastness of the content? What is the structure of the content? What are various examples, illustrations which can be included in elaboration of this content? Detailed elaboration of the content where many components, sub-chunks, sub-concepts, rules, principles are clearly written, many examples are mentioned which can lead to proper structure of the content is known as content analysis. Instructional designer needs to first do content analysis before jumping to write ODL material directly. While writing content, the question which arises is who is the ultimate target group? For whom are we writing this? In context analysis, we have seen that learner's context is important. Other than learner's environment, socio-economical background, learner's previous knowledge is important. Learner's characteristics are important. We have seen that for open and distance learning material development, we consider many characteristics of adult learners. Likewise, there may be some detailed analysis of the target group who is going to access material. Maybe previous biases, maybe age-related factors, psychological elements. So learner analysis is very important. Learner's previous knowledge, entry behavior is very crucial. And the last is goal analysis. As content is important, goals of learning are important. If we analyze goals, if we derive performance objectives, outcomes, it will help us write and develop such open and distance learning material. So, after this detailed analysis of need, context, learner, content, and goal, we start designing. What do we design first? Specific performance objectives need to be designed before developing any material, because the entire structure, treatment of the material will depend on these performance outcomes. So, specific performance outcomes should be designed for any ODL material. When we develop and design such outcomes, we also need to think about assessment of these outcomes. Whether these outcomes are being achieved or not, we need to make provision for this particular assessment strategy. So, first design assessment strategies for that particular learning. After designing outcomes and assessment strategies, one can start thinking about approach towards development of that material. What are the design strategies? What approaches, strategies we should use for making learners learn, interact with that particular content? This will help us define our approach. Instructional strategies, methods can be finalized here. We can also finalize what kind of instructional material we are going to use. We can start thinking and planning for graphics and multimedia components. If we are not using computerized material, then we can think of various photographs, illustrations. We can think of paper-based material, maybe some models. Now, the most important aspect is interactivity. ODL material needs to be interactive. It needs to engage learner. It needs to make the learner aware of his or her own progress. So, along with planning methodology, we also need to plan various activities and exercises to be embedded in this material. Now, these exercises and activities will not appear only at the end of the material, but in between. These are known as inbuilt exercises. While learning, the learner needs to come across various small exercises, some projects, some activities through which the learner can understand, use his or her previous knowledge, be ready for the next piece of content. In between, the learner will also understand how much he or she has learnt and then can proceed further. Let us go into some details of this design phase. We mentioned that writing performance outcomes is essential. But how to write these performance outcomes? Generally, we are used to use the terms like understand, know. These are considered as vague terms. We really do not come to know what we mean by learner understands meaning of ABC. If the learner has really understood meaning of ABC, what would be outcome? Whether the learner will be able to discuss something, whether the learner will be able to apply that knowledge and draw conclusion, how would you know that the learner has acquired ability of comparing? Is the learner going to compare, differentiate, distinguish? So, we need to use the verbs which will define at what level the learner can present his or her understanding, knowledge, application. Here is a list of some verbs which you can use while writing performance objectives. Breakdown, calculate, categorize, change, combine, compare, compile, compose, compute, contrast, convert, create, criticize, define, demonstrate, describe, design, devise, differentiate, discover, discriminate, discuss, distinguish, estimate, explain, give example, identify, illustrate, draw inference, interpret, judge, justify, label, list, match, measure, modify, name, operate, organize, outline, paraphrase, point out, precise, predict, prepare, produce, rewrite, recall, select, separate, show, solve, state, subdivide, summarize, transform, translate. So, here is a huge long list for you to use and write performance objectives. But remember to avoid certain verbs as they may end up making you write vague objectives. Avoid verbs like accept, appreciate, be aware of, consider, enjoy, examine, explore. Have a good grasp of, know, realize, recognize, understand. Hope it is very clear how we need to write performance outcomes. When we develop small media pieces for any open and distance learning material, for example, a small video, an audio file, some text material, some illustrations, then all these small pieces of material are called as assets. Finally, you need to assemble all these assets and give one concrete integrated form to your ODL material. This integration assembly happens at development phase. Finally, you get the entire media developed, you assemble it properly and bundle it. You also validate developed material. Please remember that the target group for any open and distance learning material is vast. There may be 1000 students, there may be 10,000 students who will sit in their own houses and access your material. So, the responsibility of validating ODLM lies on the institution. You need to try out that material on a few learners, find out effectiveness and accuracy of that material. Content validity needs to be done by allowing experts to review your material. Once this review is done, the material is validated on learners, it's ready for implementation. Along with this material, you also require proper systematic course guide for learners. Because these are distance learners, they are not going to come and ask anybody every time. Even though there may be some study centers, learners may not be able to reach to even study centers. So, when the entire packet, bundled packet reaches them, it should consist of some study material and some guide. Guide can tell them how to go about the entire course. So, start developing course guides also. The next very important phase is implementation. For implementation, you need to train even facilitators. For example, counselors at study centers. Their role is different than the teacher. E-tutors in online learning environment, even their role is different than regular face-to-face teachers. So, these facilitators need to be oriented and need to be made aware that they are facilitators and not instructors. They can support learners, they can help learners, they can guide them and solve their problems, but they are not there to teach the content entirely right from the beginning. Even learners need to be prepared. Learners may come from face-to-face situations. So, the learners also need to be prepared. They may be used to face-to-face on-campus situations. We need to make them aware that now they have to be self-directed. They need to undertake their learning activities on their own. They need to be internally motivated to learn something from this study material. They need to use this study material on their own. And if at all they have problems, they need to be told whom to contact, how to communicate. Distribution of this material to the entire target group is a challenge. Proper systematic distribution policy needs to be implemented. Even after distribution of material, the entire learning needs to go very systematically, and that's why some instructional strategies need to be implemented here. When will e-tutor interact online? What kind of discussion forums will be used? When will be their synchronous communication conferences? Everything needs to be planned and implemented accordingly. If you are not using electronic medium, then study center need to organize counseling session. So, all study centers need to be informed about the schedule and the need, duration of these counseling sessions. This is major part of implementation. The final validation of the material and processes actually happen in implementation phase. Once this validation is done, institutionalization of the material and the entire course happens. That is, the course gets implemented in each and every institution. Implementation is not the last stage. Even though we start this program, continuous evaluation is essential. Open and distance material is never an end product. There is always scope for revision of this material. There are two types of evaluation, formative evaluation and summative evaluation. Your ODL material consists of some exercises in between. The small exercises and activities are for formative assessment. At the end of the material or at the end of the block of material, there are some exercises. There are some activities to do. And at the end of the course, there is again summative assessment. Likewise, even for implementation of the entire ODL program, there are formative evaluation strategies and summative evaluation strategies. In between, we can seek feedback from learners, from all stakeholders including counselors, study center organizers, coordinators, which will give us feedback about the entire online learning system or open learning system. So, whether our open and distance learning is happening through study centers, through print based material, or whether it is happening online, in both the cases, feedback is important to us. This feedback would be formative evaluation.